the void, but somehow different this time.
Surprised I can pull you into this place? The Outsider marked me long ago. I made you flee your precious tower and turned your father into cold stone. How difficult for you. But when I was young, sweet Jessamine and I were closest sisters, sharing a secret. Emperor Caldwin had another daughter, born in shame to a kitchen maid.
Am I dreaming? If not, how is Delilah doing this?
I told you here. You're over. I missed
you. You said that last time. Jessamine's younger than me, and she's a core everything.
Jessamine's... well, it's complicated. You understand something?
What did I do? Oh, God, I swear.
Next year, I promise.
Games in the tower, but at night I'd go back to the servants' quarters to cockroaches and thin gruel. Emperor Daddy would visit and tell me if I was good. Next year I'd be old enough to come to court to be a princess. Then one day, pretty Jessamine broke something worth a fortune, and the spymaster caught us. She claimed I did it, and he whipped me in the garden house until I bled. My mother lost her kitchen job, and that night we were out on the streets with no place to sleep.
I didn't break it.
Would you like to
tell me
again?
We were just playing.
You're playing Jessamine. Who is here now?
It was her. Delilah's life. She broke it.
Nastiest parts of Dunwall, ending up in debtor's prison. Jessamine died quick on an assassin's blade, but my mother lingered for weeks after a fat guard broke her jaw. They threw me out when she died. I looked up at the lights of Dunwall Tower and swore revenge. Washing bedsheets in a brothel, I painted on the side, until Anton Sokolov took me as a student. That's the polite word for it. I was crafty even before the Outsider marked me, and survived the worst the Empire could offer. Now, it's your turn.
My mother's sick. She needs help.
Your mother kicked off while you were out begging. She's another bag of bones now, girl.
What? No!
Her sentence is served and she'll be tossed out with the others. You can't stay here anymore.
To know whether my dear old aunt is telling the truth or not.
When I was young, the loyalist conspiracy that kidnapped me also took Anton Sokolov. They brought him to the pub where I was being held and locked him in a cage meant for dogs. And you know what? Sokolov laughed at them. He taught me lessons and told me funny stories. He seemed immortal. His mind shaped our age. That's changed. The old man I rescued doesn't talk much. He eats what we give him, groans in his sleep, coughs out blood. I thought he'd tell me the secret to defeating Delilah and saving the Empire. But I'm not even sure he knows where he is.
I'm with you, even in the void. If only I could do more.
Mother? That wasn't a dream, was it?
Am I to blame for Delilah's bitterness?
No. She's the one who orchestrated the coup.
Our decisions have weight. I feel my time drawing to an end. Soon.
For a man of his age, Sokolov's making better than I would have expected.
Jindosh wanted me to help him with a rather complicated problem. It would have enabled him to make his clockwork soldiers at a fraction of the cost. Clever man.
Not clever enough. What's wrong with people like that?
Anton, when I brought you back, you could barely speak. But it's been 3 days.
They tortured him. His body is covered with bruises.
Delilah has the throne, and my father is missing. This is Anton Sokolov, the greatest mind in the Empire.
No, Emily. Megan is right. I can make electricity move from one side of the room to the other, but Delilah is beyond my understanding. When I came to Sir Konos, I meant to leave everything behind. But when the assassination started, I couldn't ignore it. By the time Megan and I connected the murders to the Duke, it was too late. The Crown Killer came for me. It kept me alive from my knowledge, but I saw things. Jindosh often had a visitor, Brianna Ashworth.
She's the curator of the Royal Conservatory.
Yes, Ashworth is dangerous. As obsessed with the occult as Delilah. Apparently, she's working on a device called the Oraculum.
There's more to her than either of you know.
If Ashworth is one of Delilah's lieutenants, I need to eliminate her. Who knows what this device is capable of, or what she's up to.
There's a spark in your eyes. Something other than hate, which surprises me given all that's happened.
Meet me at the skiff when you want to set out for the Royal Conservatory. We'll take the skiff. I don't want to bring the dreadful whale any closer than we have to. There is a small dock in Syria Gardens, close to the conservatory. That's as far as I can take you. Ready to go?
Yes, let's go.
There'll be a grand guard presence outside the Royal Conservatory. Inside, be prepared for anything. Ashworth runs with an eclectic crowd. They'll be the real danger.
Someday I'd like to know more about how you met Ashworth.
I know you would. Trust me. Ashworth is important to Delilah. Which brings up something else. You might be able to exploit the Abbey of the Everyman in removing Ashworth from play. Turns out the Vice Overseer in Karnaca has been watching Ashworth from a hidden outpost near the Royal Conservatory. Check it out first if you want more options. Remember, if she's still working with Delilah, Ashworth is a grave threat.
Thanks, Maggie. See you soon.
And spindles made of zirconian umberwood.
Both Duke Theodanus outlawed umberwood export to protect the trees.
I can't keep track of all the decrees. My client's refurbishing her gazebo, adding an exotic southern touch.
I don't get it. When I went to Dunwall, I brought back a river crush shell to use as an ashtray. Because it reminds me of good times. But what's the point of buying wood from a country you never visited?
Lady Shersha has money, so she gets the wood she wants.
For a while, I believed Ashworth has some connection to the occult in Karnaca. Something is happening that I don't understand. The overseers are the forward face of the Abbey, but equally important are our sisters from the Oracular Order. To be direct, I suspect something is wrong within their sect. Subtle changes to the types of proclamations they've been making. Small, but troubling deviations from tradition. But publicly saying anything along those lines will get me accused of heresy by my rivals within the Abbey. Is it possible that Ashworth has infiltrated the Oracular Order?
So Vice Overseer Byrne thinks Ashworth is interfering with the Oracular Order. If true, it's another reason she has to be eliminated.
Today's your lucky day, madam. It's the day you get to meet Pirate Betty in person. Time to pay the price if you want to live.
Oh, no, please! I have nothing. I'm just a poor maid.
I see you've heard the stories about Pirate Betty.
Take a look around. We have the best wares for discerning guests such. Welcome to my shop. Say, an acquaintance of mine is supposed to be holed up in an office overlooking the Royal Conservatory. Check on them if you're headed that way. I'd check myself, but the streets are locked down. I'd make it worth your time.
I'll think about it.
See anything you like? Come in, my friend. Always a delight to see you. Want blueprints for better weaponry. I'm certain you will be satisfied with your purchase. No need to wrap it for you, I suppose. This is what I have for upgrading your equipment. An excellent choice. Please visit again soon.
Incantation will work with just a little muck from the street.
Enrico said to give you his regards.
That donkey-faced cretin can open his wrist for all I care. Did you bring me something? The silver cigarette case, like we agreed?
No, listen. I can't go on doing this, stealing for you. I'll lose my job.
Do you want to be a servant all your life? You're always talking about leaving Karnaca on a big white boat, never to come back. You spend your days polishing silver cutlery. Come with me, Beatrix. Let's leave.
Could we really get passage on a ship? What if they find us?
You know I'll protect you. Just like when we were kids.
I'll think about it. I promise.
Shh.
make your way across this shuddering city. Brianna Ashworth would have been miserable as a member of high society, forced to win some bloated banker. Her only moments of real freedom, getting drunk at fancy balls, and slipping away to couple with strangers. It would have ended in an unhappy marriage and a late-night plunge into an icy river. But just before mother and father married her off, so many years ago, she found Delilah instead. It was all highways and graveyards after that. Never looking back. Vice Overseer Byrne is an ambitious man, but he believes in the Abbey's mission. Protecting the good people of the Empire against the likes of us. You know he'd be happier deep down if this ended with Brianna Ashworth's head on a spike. Maybe yours as well.
We're keeping it together, but everyone is afraid of what will happen when it really falls apart.
Thank you.
The Royal Conservatory. What do those walls hide? The conservatory. I wanted to visit this place with Wyman.
She wanted to raise the blood briar, but cannot. After trying to make grave hounds for weeks, she gave up. You should have seen the twisted things she made. All snouts and teeth and tails.
That's just the way it is, dear Parmelia. Delilah wears the outsider's mark, and some of what she can do flows down to us.
It doesn't seem fair.
Think about working your fingers raw, weaving nets, or raising cows to slaughter. Any of the gifts we receive is better than living under the boot.
That's true and fine. A wise.
What would you and Father advise if you were both here? Sometimes I dream we're all together again.
Brianna, what happened to Jindosh? I'm told he's a gibbering idiot.
whisper into the ears of the Oracular sisters.
These odd lenses might be linked to what Ashworth is working on. Vice Overseer Byrne's suspicions were right.
Delightful. And this business with Jindosh won't affect things.
No. He continued to tinker with the lenses.
Blood and biscuits. I look forward to using it.
Something from deep down in the mud where there's no light. The endless womb and the cold, dead grave.
But Brianna's effigy has let her reach into the mind, into the heart. Wouldn't you be afraid she'd influence your dreams? Like she's going to be to the city?
You, I swear! Escape!
Thank the boy.
Jindosh was tiresome. How does this even work?
Edgeworth's journal might tell me more about why Delilah can't be killed.
Delilah fell to the assassin Dawn. Her magic was lost, and the coven scattered. I made a new life in Karnaca. Then I heard her whispering from the void, leading me to the Duke, who heard those same whispers. Together we worked to bring Delilah. Back into the world, changing the Empire from the home of Aramis Stilton. 3 years ago, across the aisle, all of us who'd been with her at Brigmore and before, we felt the magic return. Others joined. New faces, new blood. Now, Delilah is immortal. Forever. She holds Dunwall, and we've turned to corrupting the Oracular Order. The Overseers take guidance from their prophetic sisters, and soon we'll influence their dreams and visions.
They accept my transfer. I've got to get over to one of the other districts.
Welcome back. Welcome back. I see you found the prototype.
Your acquaintance didn't make it.
It is a risky line of work, I'm afraid, but let's not dwell. I expect you'll be interested in payment. First, your finder's fee, of course, and if you like, I can draw up some schematics based on the prototype, something you can use to modify your tools. And as a token of my appreciation, a discount at the shop.
A fair deal.
What a pleasant surprise to see you again. It's a pleasure to have such a unique young lady. Let's see. I have some upgrade plans for your gear. No need to wrap it for you, I suppose. An excellent choice. I'm certain you will be satisfied with your purchase. It was a pleasure to serve you.
So it's done.
Ashworth won't be a problem anymore.
Good. But Emily, there's something else. Back when I lived in Dunwall, I did things that I'm not proud of.
Isn't that a requirement for citizenship?
What I've got to say is not a joke. I knew Delilah and Ashworth. Bought into their bullshit. Which led me down a bad road. To be honest, before all this, I thought Delilah dead. I don't want to get into it right now. But I felt like you should know. There are things I regret.
All right, Megan. Thank you for opening up. If only a little.
I'm starting to feel like you deserve it. Are you ready to leave now?
Yes. Let's go. Take me back to the Dreadful Whale.
Another step toward the Duke of Cirkonos and Delilah.
For several years, Delilah's been here, getting stronger, turning people against me. Why didn't I see it coming? What was I doing during that time? Pretending to listen at court, ruling through an army of bureaucrats, waiting for the next chance to get free of Dunwall Tower. Well, now I'm free. If only I could go back. Aramis Stilton was once an ally of the Duke. The owner of Karnaca's mines, Stilton lives in a fortified bunker at the heart of the Dust District. No one's seen him for years, since around the time Delilah started making her moves. But whether Stilton's alive or dead, his home holds the key to Delilah's immortality.